In this quick tutorial, I'm going to show you how to set up a basic calendar grid in InDesign using tables. Okay, so let's get started. We're going to start off with a new page, all right? We're going to keep the defaults as they are, letter size document. The only thing we're going to change is the orientation. We're going to make that landscape, and we'll say okay. Now, next up, we want to work on the master or the parent page. So double-click on that. Make sure you're on the parent page or the master. All right, and we're going to create a text frame. It's going to go from margin to margin, left to right, top to bottom. Okay, then using the text tool, we're going to go up to tables, insert table, and we're going to say give us 6 rows, 7 columns. We'll say okay. Now, the very top row, we want to keep the height the same, but we want to modify the 5 rows underneath. The way we're going to do that is we're going to grab the bottom edge of the table, just click it and drag it down so it snaps into the bottom margin. Very good. Next up, we're going to highlight those 5 rows. Remember, we're going to keep the top row at the same height. And we're going to say go table, drop down to distribute rows evenly. So now we have the basic grid. The very top row is going to have the actual days. And then these cells down here, they will have the numbers. So that's step one. Next up, we're going to modify our style so that we can have 2 styles in this document. We want to have our basic paragraph style, of course, and then we're going to have a second style that's going to be called numbers. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to call up our styles palette, and we're going to say you've already put your days in that top row. Let's highlight that, and we're going to center it from left to right, and then we're going to go up to tables, drop down to where it says cell options, slide over to text, and we will say, let's center it top to bottom, center it left to right, and we'll say okay. And if you notice, once we did that, the little plus sign came up here next to the basic paragraph style, not a problem, because we modified it. So we'll tap on that little grid right there, and then we're going to drop down to where it says redefine styles so that now that is our new basic paragraph style is going to be centered from left to right, top to bottom in these cells. That's step two. Step three is going to be we're going to actually assign a second style, which we're going to call numbers. And now let's jump right into that. What we want to do is we're going to say click off so nothing is selected, tap on the actual, you know, create new style button at the bottom. We created the style. We're going to double click on that. We're going to drop down to where we'll start off with the indents and spacing, and we're going to say we want to make the alignment, we want to make that flush right, okay? And then this is the key. We want to make the actual, when we go down, we're going to make that style. We're going to use bullets and numbering. So let's name this numbers. All right. Tap on bullets and numbers. List style, numbers. And it's going to activate this area right here. This is the key. What you want to do is you want to highlight, everything past that hashtag or the pound sign and delete it. So you just have the caret sign and the pound sign, and we'll say okay. And then what we're going to do is we're going to highlight all of these frames where the numbers will go. Go up to table, drop down to cell options, and what we're going to do is we're going to say text. And instead of having it is aligned to top. That's good. So let's go numbers, all right? And we have right here. So now you can see all the numbers are aligned to top, to the right. Now we're going to actually put the numbers in place. And here's how you do that. You're going to put your cursor right there on the first frame, and you're going to number every single one of these frames, and it's going to go from 1 to 35. And the way you do that is you tap the space bar, and you're going to notice the number pops up. Go to the next one, tap. Tap, drop down, tap, 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 drop down, tap. Remember, you're not typing in any numbers. You're just putting in, just hitting the space, putting a space. And every time you put a space, it numbers consecutively. And we're going to number all the way to 35. Now, we know that no month has 35 days, but we have to populate every single one of these frames to be able to do what we need to do next. So now we have the numbers in place. Let's go to the next step. Okay, here's how you can modify the actual frames, you know, or the grids when they're in position. What I did was I added three pages with the master page item on them. And as you know, when I try to select them, I can't select them because they're part of the master. So what I need to do is, in order to make these changes, I'm going to start with page one. In order to make, you know, changes, I have to release it from the master. And the way you do that is, you have to, if I'm on the Mac, you put your fingers on these two modifier keys, Shift-Command and click. Shift-Command and click, and if you're on the PC, it's Shift-Control and click. Once you've done that, you've released it from the master. As you can see, I can move it around, I can edit it, I can do anything I want to do. So now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to start to change the numbering of these frames within this grid. So let's say, for example, is say, okay, I have a month where the first day of the month is on Thursday. All I have to do is highlight going from Sunday to Wednesday, hit the delete key, and guess what? Now it starts on Thursday, and it goes all the way to the end, all right? So now that's one scenario. That's how easy it is to move things around. Let's take a look at the second scenario. So now I'm on page two. Again, since it's a master page item, I have to release it from the master, and I can make adjustments. So let's say I have a month that starts on Tuesday. So I'll delete the first two frames. You can see it starts on Wednesday, it starts on Tuesday. But then I have these extra months right here, these extra days, I should say. Highlight them, delete them. All right, so now you have 1 through 31 starting on Tuesday. Now the third option is a little more complicated, but let's see how this works. Let's just say we have a month that starts on Saturday. So again, release it from the master, highlight up to Friday, delete it, one. But as you can see, it ends at 29, and we need to put two more days in there. And typically the way you do that with these calendars is these two cells right here double up. So let's see how we can do that. We're going to highlight those two cells. We're going to go up to table, again, drop down to cell options, and we'll say diagonal lines. Now I'm going to click the third option that basically splits it diagonally in half. I'll say okay. While I still have those two selected, what I'm going to do is instead of being flush right, I'm going to make them flush left. So now what I want to do is I want to add the missing days here. So what I'll do is I'll put in a return, just the return. Don't type anything, just return. And then what I'm going to do is, under when I type the return under the 23, what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the actual paragraph style from numbers to basic paragraph. I'll do the same thing here. Tap there, change that to basic paragraph. Now I'm going to manually type in 30 under 23 and then 31 under 24. All right, and then when I type those in, I'm going to flush that one to the right, and then I will flush that one to the right. So now I have a situation where I was able to split the actual cells and put in the additional numbers so that I can actually have the thing that I want as far as how to duplicate the actual days within the cell. Voila, there you have it. So here's how you can use tables to be able to create a basic grid in InDesign. Hopefully that helps.